YouTube, Edgar here, and welcome to Artifexian. Here you will learn everything you ever wanted to know about world building, and then some. So this particular story starts 4.6 billion years ago, when gravity caused a giant molecular cloud to collapse and begin forming our sun. The cloud that spawned our sun is thought to have measured 65 light years across. As it collapsed, it fragmented into several 1 parsec wide regions, and inside each of these regions a star began to form. Scientists believe that our sun formed within a cluster of several thousand other stars. Now when this giant cloud collapsed, it had a little bit of angular momentum, so not all the matter collapsed into the central star forming region. Material also began to orbit around the proto-sun, forming a protoplanetary disk roughly 200 AU in diameter. It is in this disk that the planets as we know them began to form. The disk was composed of gas and dust. Now, when I say dust, I don't mean dust in the household sense. Rather, cosmic dust is comprised of tiny rock particles less than a micron in size. These grains began to stick together and grew in size until they formed 1 kilometer wide objects known as planetesimals. These 1 kilometer planetesimals were massive enough to begin gravitationally attracting each other, and as a result they continued to grow in size through a process known as accretion. Once massive enough, gravity caused runaway accretion to occur, which sped up the growing process of these planetesimals. It's thought that the inner solar system at this point contained 50 to 100 moon to Mars sized objects, known as planetary embryos. Now, for reasons unknown to science, the planetary disk is thought to have lost much of its gas at this point, which caused the orbits of these planetary embryos to become unstable. This instability led some of these protoplanets to collide, forming the planets as we know them today. Such collisions are thought to have formed the moon and removed Mercury's atmosphere. Close into our sun, rocky planets formed because the temperatures were high enough to allow for the accretion of high boiling point materials like iron, nickel, and aluminium. The rarity of these heavy elements placed an upper limit on how big rocky planets could grow. The gas giants formed out beyond what is known as the frost line. Here it was cold enough for volatile icy compounds to be solid. The gas giants are thought to have rocky cores of roughly 5 to 10 Earth masses. This critical level caused a process called hydrostatic flow to occur, sucking in all the hydrogen and helium gas and sticking it to the core, forming a thick gaseous atmosphere or envelope. When the protosun had gained enough mass to begin nuclear fusion in its core, it sent a shockwave through the planetary disk, essentially clearing out all the excess material in the disk, and for the most part, ending planet formation. Any materials left over after the solar winds tore through our system became the asteroid belt, Kuiper belt, and Oort cloud. Interestingly though, Uranus and Neptune are thought to have formed after the solar wind because they contain much less hydrogen and helium than Jupiter or Saturn. Planetary migration is a poorly understood yet essential part of how our solar system came to be. Simply put, it is believed that Neptune and Uranus formed much closer into our sun and then migrated outwards, whilst the inner solar system planets tended to migrate inwards, eventually slotting into the nice, orderly configuration we call our solar system. Guys, check the description for links to my Facebook and Twitter, but more importantly, like and subscribe right here on YouTube. Thank you all so much for watching. Edgar out.